Hello, the internet. Welcome to our video series, Special Reports, all about great reporting in AdWords. My name is Sean Quadlin. I'm a product marketing manager here at Google, focusing specifically on SEM best practices. Now, smart analysis and reporting in AdWords highlights what matters to you and your bottom line. In this video series, we're going to talk about how to surface the right insights and then turn those insights into action. An important first step towards successful analysis is knowing what success is for you. In this video, we're going to cover two things: how to define clear and consistent success metrics, and how to focus on insights that lead to changes that affect your success metrics. To start, define clear and consistent success metrics. Everyone has goals for AdWords, right? But a crucial part of those goals is consistency. Make your goals well-defined and stable. Customize your performance goals based on what your desired outcome is. This customization can even be for different parts within your account. It's up to you, but it needs to matter to you. And then when putting together analyses, include secondary metrics that then directly relate to that success metric. There are plenty of different ways to gauge success in AdWords, but no matter what success looks like for you, focus on what matters most. For example, click-through rate may affect performance, but don't let it or any other secondary metric distract you from your true measure of success. Next, you should focus on insights that lead to changes that affect your success metrics. Once you have a clear sense of what success is for you, you can create analyses in AdWords to identify ways to then improve performance. Connect those secondary metrics to your primary success metric and create analyses that then lead to action. It isn't enough to find something that's interesting. You need to find something that's interesting that also leads directly to optimizations for your account. If you start by understanding what's happening in your account, you can dig in just a bit deeper to uncover why something might be occurring. From there, you can take steps to replicate successes and eliminate shortcomings. Start with your overall success metric, create a report that illuminates a certain facet of that metric, and then use that report to drive action. So in this example here, target cost per acquisition is probably going to be affected by cost per click and conversion rate. When you're putting together reports, you want to focus on things that either affect cost per click or conversion rate, and then layer it back to your main primary metric. It's a simple enough concept, but I think it's worth reinforcing. It's really important to keep that front and center in your mind, that main success metric. So when you're talking about reporting in AdWords, you want to define clear and consistent success metrics, and then focus on insights that lead to changes that affect those success metrics. Please check out the rest of the videos in our series, all about great reporting in AdWords. Thanks for watching.